Okay, dear friends, we are going to start this program. I want to introduce you to Genevieve, who is going to be our MC. I am Sergio, and I am one of the founders of the SaccoVanzetti Commemoration Society. It's a pleasure to be here for the 10th time on the streets of Boston. So, Genevieve is going to do her stuff.
Thanks everybody for coming out. I'm Genevieve, I'm with the industrial workers of the world. And we're gonna start. We've got an awesome band here. We've got some speeches. We're gonna start with some music from Raphael right now. So welcome Raphael. SaccoVanzetti Presente.
Thank you. Hola, hola. ¿Cómo están?
Bien.
So, I guess, well, I'm just going to do with one mic. So we're going to share a little bit of music, I guess. We can be out of tune, out of sync, yet together we're powerful. So, I'm not going to say too much about workers' rights, immigration, immigrants' rights. If we're here, we all know it very well. There's a lot of work to be done, never ending. So, since the struggle is ongoing, so shall be the joy that moves us, the music that inspires us, because sometimes it gets really hard and we still have to keep on going. So hopefully there's a beat, like the beat of our heart, and it keeps us moving. So here we're gonna do a little improvisation based on a rhythm that a lot of people know a lot, and I guess they call it La Bamba. But the lyrics may sound suspiciously different than La Bamba. And maybe I need your help. I'm gonna need everybody to at some point clap, or maybe even the band can help a little bit with the percussion. And those of you who wanna dance, you can dance too. I guess we're gonna sing a little bit in Spanish, a little bit in English, maybe a little bit in Italian, maybe a little bit in Portuguese. And maybe everybody can collaborate with some sort of chorus. The chorus goes like this. We're gonna put some words, and those words are gonna be piercing, loving, full of joy, full of strength to celebrate our struggle. And we can say them in English, in Spanish, in whatever we want. Here we go. Are we ready? Compartir. compartamos las historias que tenemos y así juntos podremos construir un mundo mejor. Y ni siquiera hablemos de amor, del amor de esos locos cuyo que se dicen enamorados. La Bamba, are you ready? It says something like, el pueblo unido jamás será vencido. El pueblo unido jamás será vencido. The people united will never be defeated. And now we're gonna give it a little bit of rhythm here. Here we go. El pueblo unido jamás será vencido. Let's go.
Bando de Paz El Salvador presente. It's a pleasure to welcome this year our brothers and sisters from the Boston Bando de Paz El Salvador. Now, as we speak to SaccoVanzetti, two Italian immigrants, working for labor rights. We are actually gone so many years since those days, since 1927, when they were executed. Yet, some of the reasons why they were executed is because they were immigrants. It's very clear then that the Italians of those days were the Mexicans of today, were the Latinos of today, from any country in Latin America. This is why it is pertinent for us, even though we are not Italian, even though many of us are not anarchists, to be here remembering them, honoring their memory, because they were executed on the electric chair by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, by the society that ruled in those days, because even Harvard University, MIT, all those institutions were involved in this assassination of SaccoVanzetti. It is pertinent that we, the immigrants of today, are here remembering SaccoVanzetti. It's also pertinent that the anarchists that are with us today remember their comrades, their brave comrades, and they remember them with dignity because they die dignified, struggling for the working class. And now I want to say a few words in Spanish. Compañeros, compañeras, es un placer tenerlos a ustedes no solamente como músicos hoy día, sino tenerlos como inmigrantes en este evento que recuerda a SaccoVanzetti.
I just have a short speech to give. 88 years ago, two Italian men were murdered by the state of Massachusetts. They were anarchists and workers, one a simple shoemaker, one sold fish. Their names were Nicola Sacco and Bartolomeo Vanzetti. Despite their constant denial of committing any crimes ever, some sins, but no crimes, those are the words of Vanzetti himself, those were his last words. They were found guilty of murder by a clearly biased jury. We are familiar with this now, and all too familiar with police acting as judge, jury, and executioner. We see racism in the courts, where these killers get freed after taking the lives of young black men and women. We see the injustices and the racist rhetoric coming from presidential candidates regarding people coming here simply looking for a better life. We as anarchists must stand and fight these true crimes. We must educate the public, the young people, for they will take over from us, the banners and the black flags. This country has made prisoners. More prisoners than any other country in the world.
I would fight for it again if I had to fight for the Bill of Rights. I'm not going to fight for the Constitution. That's fighting for the government. The Bill of Rights is what protects us. That's what I would fight for. And I will do that as long as I stand and as long as I breathe. And I hope all of you will too. And as we move forward, we will realize that each and every last one of us, brother and sister alike, are human beings that drink the same water, breathe the same air, walk the same earth, and the only thing we want is dignity. We ask for nothing more. I thank you, and I wish you all a wonderful day.
For Franco, for Sacco and Vanzetti, presente, and may there never be another day like that again. Thank you.
That's, you know, if he had been there, then he would have, I think, fit in pretty well, considering what happened to SaccoVanzetti. So next, let's just do one more time. SaccoVanzetti, presente. So next, I would like to welcome up here John Harris. He's from the Communist Party USA. Come on up.
Woo.
Woo-hoo.
Hi there. I feel proud to be here today among working class people. Sacco and Vanzetti, first and foremost, they were working class people, immigrants fighting for justice for working class people. They were organizers who stood up and fight. That's what made them different. Ordinary working class people. And I thought I would read a poem today that talks about working class people in a factory setting. And, well, I hope you like it. It's called Working on the Line. Waking at the crack of dawn, drag across the floor. Shower keeps me moving on, soon I'm out the door. Make it with a bit to spare, clock in when it's time. Every day I do my share, working on the line. Now the line is starting up, hands now feel some pain. See the next job creeping up, rhythm in my brain. Products made consistently, all our work combined. Cogs and wheels of industry, working on the line. Soon my hands don't feel the weight, part of a machine. Mind and body separate, like I'm in a dream. Morning break is coming soon, line shuts down at 9. Whistling a happy tune, working on the line. Cruz works close to chemicals, he's a piece of work. Cursing women's genitals, some say he's a jerk. Floor is forced to work two jobs, paycheck worth a dime. Could it be your health is robbed? Working on the line. Fridays when we get our check, we forget the pain. Ball and chain around our neck, another week the same. Some folks shout while others sing, Benny smells of wine. Some half crazy, do our thing, working on the line. Living hard while chasing dreams we may catch someday. Thinking of those two extremes, one so far away. Some know better after years, old before their time. When the future disappears, working on the line. Then they start to dream again, for the kids it seems. Planning for a future when they can live their dreams. Wai Ling doing packaging, does her work with pride. Talks about life in Beijing, working on the line. Many come in here to stay, far away from home. Looking for a better day, all roads lead to Rome. Esperanza likes to joke, says she's doing fine. In Honduras, she was broke, working on the line. Guatemala genocide, death throughout the land. A colossal fratricide? One blames Uncle Sam. Tales of the kleptocracies as they undermine methods of democracy, working on the line. Genocide Cambodia, a horrific show. Khmer Rouge utopia, Keen was there, he knows. Gathered in a melting pot, futures intertwine. Taking orders is our lot, working on the line. As the years out on the floor, traveled since my youth, took me on a world tour where I learned some truth. Seems that we create their wealth, those whose mansions shine. As we're stuck out on a shelf, working on the line. Taking pride in what we do, making something real. There's another point of view, something that we feel. Could there be a better way, one we can design? We who toil our lives away, working on the line. Thanks. Woo!
Thank you.
ustedes hacen? ¿Cómo marchan más o menos? ¿A qué paso? Pero...
So that people can understand that bigotry, that racism, that anti-immigration sentiments, anti-radical sentiments, all of those problems that were present openly in 1927 are still with us today, unfortunately. And we have been seeing this on the streets of the United States, where our police, actually not our police, but the police that defends the state, is actually killing our own people. And that is not, of course, something that a police department should be doing. And in particular, they are concentrating in killing people of color, black people, Latino people, in particular. If you are black or if you are Latino, you are deemed to be ready to be killed if necessary for whatever move you might make, which is a sad state of affairs.
Okay, one, two, guitarra desafinada. Okay, so welcome. It says a lot when people that could be shopping in a mall today are in a different kind of mall for a different kind of experience. ¿Cuántas veces veces pienso, compañero, que aunque digan que somos distintos, compartimos la misma esperanza, necesitamos lo mismo. La solución, revolución desde el corazón y desde ahí para adelante. Déjame que cante, deja que te cuente lo que mi alma siente cuando veo tanta gente indiferente que se olvida de compartir, que si empiezas a cambiar vos también no tendrás otra opción que ser parte de la solución. Y aquí estamos en la lluvia viendo el sol de un nuevo amanecer que compartimos, haciendo un mundo mejor, paso a paso cada día, que no nos quiten la revolución del alma, que es el pan nuestro de cada día. Yo respeto que seamos distintos, siempre que reconozcamos antes que distanciarnos. Oh, 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 que nuestro canto y nuestro trabajo no sea en vano, no sea en vano. Oh, oh. Demasiado villano, demasiado dolor a contramano. Por eso yo te canto mi llanto y comparto la soledad de mi corazón, que no quiere resignarse a que seamos parte de una maquinita que se agita y que nos roba hasta la más pequeña ilusión, las ganas de comer y de sentir nuestro derecho de ejercer la libertad de crecer para ser un país que vive justicia y que no nos quiera robar, porque si no nada nos va a quedar, pero aquí estamos. Así tejemos nuestro destino, compartiendo hasta el pan y el vino.
Deserve recognition and acknowledgement for their fight that doesn't stop when they were killed. They continue, so we are all here to celebrate today. Thank you. Woo!
And where is JP?
Can I ask somebody to come up and lead it who is better at singing than I am?
You are. You have to be.
You want to lead? No, you need. But you are a singer.
Oh, really?
Okay,
so everybody better sing really loud because I'm leading.
Hey, gather around, Wobblies. Right. Gather around, Wobblies.
The union's inspiration
through the workers' blood shall run. There can be no power greater anywhere beneath the sun.
Plowed the prairies, built the workshop where they trade, dug the mines and built the workshop, endless miles of railroad lay. Now we stand outcast and starving midst the wonders we have made, while the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever, solidarity forever, solidarity forever. While the union makes us strong,
what are we holding common
with the greedy parasite who would lash us into serfdom and would crush us with his might? Is there anything left to us but to organize and fight? While the union makes us strong, solidarity forever, solidarity forever. Solidarity forever, while the union makes us strong. All the world is owned by idle drones, there's Arthur North alone. We have laid the wide foundations, built it skyward stone by stone. It is ours not to slave in, but to master and to own. While the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever, solidarity forever, while the union makes us strong. They have taken unknown millions, which they never toiled to earn, but without our brains and muscles, not a single wheel can turn. We can break their haughty power, gain our freedom when we learn that the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever, solidarity forever, solidarity forever, while the union makes us strong. In our hands is laid a power greater than their hoarded gold, greater than the strength of armies multiplied a thousandfold. We can bring to life a new world from the ashes of the old, while the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever, solidarity forever, solidarity forever, while the union makes us strong.
Los humildes gorriones de los diarios, los obreros del puerto se persignan, no callarán jamás de frente al crimen. ¿Qué ha de ser de la vida si el que canta no levanta su voz en las tribunas? Por el que sufre, por el que no hay ninguna razón que lo condene a andar sin manta.
Si se calla el cantor, muere la rosa. ¿De qué sirve la rosa sin el canto? Debe el canto ser luz sobre los campos.
And it speaks to the just the disgusting conditions that people worked under, and their desire to live freely and live according to their own desires versus the opposite. And so there's many versions of the song. I'm going to play the original song that was sung in the fields that became the sort of hymn against, of the fight against fascism around the world. It's one of the most well-known anti-fascist songs. And so, for those who aren't familiar with the lyrics, I'm actually really just picking them up myself, but everybody knows the old Bella Ciao, Bella Ciao, Bella Ciao, Ciao, Ciao. So, I'm gonna play it really quick, and if people can join in, I'll play the first verse one time. Everybody can get an idea of what it sounds like, and then I'll play from the beginning. Thank you very much.
Talk about some awesome immigrant organizing over in East Boston.
How's everybody doing?
Good.
Thanks for having me today. First, I just wanted to say, standing right here, you know, I have kind of mixed feelings about coming out to the North End today. In some ways, the North End has been like a kind of a refuge for me as someone who grew up Italian American in a mostly Irish American place. I was called Guinea all the time. Sometimes I was called a greasy Puerto Rican because apparently if you're not as white as they want you to be, you're automatically on the other side, right? That's what they want to do is they want to polarize us into those that fit and those that don't fit. You know, I came here as a kid. My sister lived here and worked in the restaurants around here. I spent my weekends in the streets of this neighborhood with the kids in the neighborhood who were not only Italian, they were Moroccan, Algerian, Chilean. And, you know, where are those people now? Some of them are still working here, but how many of them can still afford to live here or are welcomed here? You know, I was, when I came here as an adult, I lived here for a couple of years, and my first day in the neighborhood, my downstairs neighbor, Joanne, said to me, "Are you Italian?" And of course, because I was able to say yes, she brought me up some pizzellis and we had a good relationship. She told me, "Oh yeah, I work out down in the Coast Guard base with the immigrants." Meaning that she worked at the Immigrant Detention Center, which has since been moved to South Bay Jail. I come here as a member of a revolutionary organization, Black Rose Anarchist Federation, but also as a member of a community organization of tenants in East Boston. The Northside Tenants Association was started about 7 years ago. It was initiated by a group of anarchists who were working in conjunction with City Life Vida Urbana, reacting to the foreclosure crisis, and also just looking for ways that we can continue to build people power. To Portland, Oregon-based developer Girding Edlin is building 163 luxury apartments on what's currently known as the New Street Project. Girding Edlin prides itself on what they call green development. Green development for who? These projects only make green for the owners, pushing working class people out to the suburbs where they are isolated and more dependent on environmentally destructive fossil fuels. Simultaneously, the erection of these large-scale, high-priced housings, the FBI is building their new regional headquarters across the Chelsea Creek in Chelsea, which is a heavily immigrant and refugee city whose downtown was the first in the US to be 100% monitored by video surveillance. Capitalist individualism is repackaged as the American dream. uprooting the legacy of working class immigrants' movements for collective liberation, not just individual advancement. Revolutionary ideas and organizations have largely lost currency in working class communities in the United States, but there is a resurgence that is growing stronger every day. Those in power will always discredit us and criminalize us because Vanzetti's dream, as opposed to the American dream, which is our dream, Vanzetti's dream, threatens the foundations of the white supremacist capitalist system. In order to realize his dream, we must act now. We need a mass movement to defend ourselves against displacement. We need to organize block by block to build independent organizations of tenants. In the words of the late Black Panther, New African anarchist political prisoner, and tenant organizer, Kwesi Balogun, quote, where we live and work, we must not only escalate discussion in study groups, we must organize on the ground level. The landlords must be contested through rent strikes, and rather than developing strategies to pay the rent, we should develop strategies to take the buildings. Today, that type of revolutionary vision can still be acted on if we organize together. Listen to ourselves, listen to each other, and take direct action to bring it about. At a minimum, in the words of Bartolomeo Vanzetti, a roof for every family, bread for every mouth, education for every heart, and enlightenment for every intellect. Power to the people. Woo! Power to the people.
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 Power to the people!
Power to the people!
Power to the people!
Black lives matter!
Black lives matter!
Black lives matter!
Black lives matter!
Thank you so much!
Viva la anarquía!
Viva la anarquía!
Viva la anarquía!
Viva la anarquía! Viva la revolución social! Viva!
Like Genevieve said, my name is Monica. I'm here both as a member of Black Rose and as a member of the group, the Somerville 18, who was involved in a Black Lives Matter solidarity action that took place in January. And we're currently in a somewhat involved court proceedings, like a lot of other folks who participated in these autonomous but simultaneous actions that took place across the country earlier this year in the wake of Ferguson and the beginning of the Black Lives Matter movement. So it's interesting and kind of awful the response that we're getting that we believe is very specifically about the messaging of opposing white supremacy. We're facing jail time and really exorbitant fees and restitution to essentially pay the cops overtime. And a couple other things that activists across the country are sort of in the same struggle. So that's kind of where I'm coming from speaking today. And you know, part of these court proceedings, us as activists are showing up and we have a lot of support and it's really necessary and appreciated. And the reality is that there's also so many people who are caught up in the system who very much do not have the privilege of having, you know, mad other activists come and show up at our court dates and help get our cases resolved more quickly. Sandra Bland, an outspoken radical, was stopped for a minor traffic violation and ended up being killed in police custody days later, with authorities telling us that this woman, preparing for an impressive new job opportunity, had committed suicide. Just last week in St. Louis, 18-year-old Mansur Balbe was shot in the back and killed by police. I hope not to list these tragedies in vain, but in compassionate memory for the stolen lives and affected communities, and to remind us all to understand them as part of the same tactic of repression, criminalization, and dehumanization of anyone who threatens white supremacy and capitalism. So the same mechanisms that were used to criminalize and execute SaccoVanzetti. When we think back to our anarchist predecessors and the political landscape of the early 1900s, it can seem pretty striking how successfully radicals were demonized. Right here in the North End, we have examples from an attempt to put responsibility for the Great Molasses Flood on anarchists to the execution of Sacco and Vanzetti we're gathered around today. this very intentional creation of leftists as dangerous functions as a tool of counterinsurgency to make us spur the idea of resistance. The same tool is used in this way to criminalize entire groups of people. Black people, indigenous people, poor people, immigrant people, transgender people. We need to keep building relationships that threaten the social order we're fighting and can take us from rebellion to revolution. Thanks.